Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are going to see a couple of 7 battles. In one battle, a high risk, high reward, gold noob. And in other battle, fellas, you are going to see the IS7 with a loadout, which I got up to the third mark of excellence, which is 15 standards, 10 APCRs, 5 high explosives. And it's going to be quite close game and quite interesting one, let's say like that. The score of that game is not going to be super duper hyper turbo epic, but the play against one opponent is going to be very, very, very good. Let's say like that. Anyways. What we are doing right here, guys, we are taking the high risk, high reward position, right? And there's quite some plays like this in World of Tanks, and this is one of those. Why so? Because sometimes you can get there and you can do shit, you can be useless, and sometimes you can farm like pretty much all enemies. In this battle, it's going to be quite a good game, and we are going to see a lot of shots right here. So anyways, you are crossing through the river just like this. And now, fellas, look at this beauty. We have the Super Conqueror, which is not paying attention at the maxi map, and all we need to do now, we need to chill, relax, and take it easy here. By the way, this position is not really working if enemies have like 2-3 Artas, and if Arta is over there, right, you are not safe in this position, and if Arta is over there, you are not safe where I am playing now. So what that basically means? You would get into huge shithole, and you can't do anything, because it happened for me before, and I learned that a hard way, let's say like that. Funny enough, fellas, IS7 to get the third mark of excellence was like very enjoyable and very easy gaming experience for me, and I must admit I kind of had a blast while doing so, right? Speaking about the IS7 up to 100% grind, I mean, you can see by the loadout, you can see by the by a lot of things right here. I'm using every single advantage which I can get in order to deal with this vehicle. So it was quite painful gaming experience, or you need to get those games, you know, you need to get those games where you can get a huge score combined and so on. Anyways, what we are doing here, we are just waiting for free shots from the enemy side, because going in front right here, it's quite dangerous, because you never know where is that fava. Maybe that fava is already going like this or something, you never know. You need to be patient right here. It's not that simple as you might think it is, you know, just spank your fingers and the damage will come. Well, but looking into the maxi map, there is T62A, but I have the shot into the 50B, so I decided to shoot him. And poor soul, T62A came here. And as you can see, he's looking like a Shrek, he have a green turret, let's send him back to his swamp. T62A is down, yip yip hooray, but we are just starting, fellas. We are just starting right here. So 277 in this kind of position, I mean, I am sitting hold down, he's sitting in the open field. I don't really know what he was thinking, but he is trying to side scrap. You don't believe in me? Look. Meanwhile, Fava is crossing through the bridge, and we are building ourselves the gun depression right here. You see, this position is extremely flexible. You can farm people over there, and over there. It's just excellent, right? And speaking about the 277, I'm thinking you want to pick, don't you? And this is the flattest angle which this guy could give for us, so he made a huge mistake right here, and he have no rights to complain about that. And now he's probably just going on me while saying, "You mother trucker gold noob, IS7, I thought I had a better tank." By the way, this is a question which I'm getting quite often. Which tank is better, 277 or IS7? And I can tell you that 277 is better tank for like very experienced players, but IS7 is way more friendly to play with, and IS7 in my opinion have better armor. So once again, everything is depending on you, right? So What we are doing now, we are just making a pressure like this because we just want to get maximum use of all this. Framing like this. Unfortunately, we are not penetrating this guy, but fellas, the pre-aim was good. You know, when you want to hit those shots or when you need to hit those shots, it is highly RNG dependent, let's say like that. Now, if you would pay attention at the ammunition which I have, I'm loading high explosives. Why so? Yep. 500 in the face of the FAVA, and I want to go aggressively right here, right? So maybe we will get another shot. And klurkst, another shot. 668. Now, I got the questions in this kind of situation. Why I run away or kind of run away? Pay attention. In front of us, we have the 430U, right? 430U just hit us. I have gold. I'm loading gold because I don't have any standards whatsoever. I am already escaping. You know why I am escaping? You saw the trees fallen in the right side. Pay attention. 430U, he's playing in platoon. With what he's playing in platoon? 50B. So what I thought the 50B is going to be already very, very close. And 50B will try to support the 430U. That was my initial thought, right? So what we are doing, we are hitting him once, although I took two for the team, but it doesn't matter, and I'm already running. Because you might think, Skill, you could fight against him. Sure, I could, but there is a 50B which is going on me without smile on his face. I am aiming for tracks. Hip hip hooray, the 50B is going in front, he penetrated me once, he's using APCR, and it's not a bad thing, because 50B, you know, if you want to be competitive with 50B and you want to shoot the heavy tanks, it's way easier to deal with that with APCR, shell velocity, penetration, and so on, so on. So I believe that makes sense, right? What this guy did right here. And all we need to do right now, we need to clear the enemy forces right here. The IS-4 is taking one more for the team, and he is dead. Let's get real. The IS-4 is going to die right here, right? I'm trying to get the shot on him, but unfortunately he's hiding right here, and I'm trying to cross the bridge, and you know, unfortunately there is a Grille which is sniping from the back. But listen, I did not lose too much use in this kind of situation, and I was thinking if I will go in front, maybe I can spot the Grille itself, and maybe it's going to be a good thing. But now looking back into this replay, I did not lose too much use whatsoever, right? So I am feeling quite Gucci right here. So in this situation, in this battle, I think this performance was very, very good, and everything what I did right here was pretty much nice. Obviously, I could survive the battle by playing a bit more passive and by staying in the back and waiting until our light tanks will spot the Grille, but it is not the case. Anyways, what we are going to do now, I have the replay from my third marking session, right? And how everything is looking here, it's going to be, let's say like that, interesting. If I'm not mistaken, this is the third Mark of Excellence battle. If I'm not mistaken, okay? And start of this game is going to be very slow. And I can tell you that it's kind of annoying when you want to do quite some things, let's say like that, but you simply can't. So now let's pay attention at the setup right here. What do we have? First things first, three Artas, okay? And playing in the middle, I already shit my pants, and I am not even thinking about playing in the middle over there, right? I simply think it's not going to be a good idea just because of the Artas. Now, going all the way around like this, you are kind of Arta open right here. Yes, it's not the easiest shot for Arta to hit you, but in the same time, imagine that. You are playing over there and enemies have the hill. Then it's not the best case scenario for you, if we can say so. And it's not going to be very enjoyable gaming experience, so keep this in mind. So what kind of option do we have left right here? In my opinion, there is only one play which we can do, and that only one play is to go like this, right? I believe that makes sense, and yes, matchmaking is good. I could go and play in the middle, but I'm so paranoid with Arthas, you know. I just have a fear, let's say like that. And when I'm seeing three of them, I need to think a bit differently, because you never know what Arthas is going to do. Are they going to focus you or not, since we have such a thing as XVM in the game, which is showing the player stats in the battle, so how good player is, or however you are calling that. So it's not, let's say like that, the most pleasant gaming experience. And what do I want to do right here, guys? I want to get some shots into the crossing forces like this. I try to go for a blind shot, but I don't really think we hit that one. And as you can see, prototype is going piri-piri-piri just like this. So what I am thinking right here, I am thinking to go a bit more aggressive here. Now, listen me up. Why am I doing this? Because usually, there is clickers which is sitting around this area. And if it's the case, if clickers is sitting right here, then you can spot them. And look. There is three Arthas. There is a high chance those clickers which got spotted is going to take one for the team. And as you can see, both of the Arthas just got murdered. And more likely we are getting a blind assisting damage on them. What blind assisting damage means? It means when tanks is not spotted anymore, they might... whenever they are getting killed, like 1 or 2 seconds after they got spotted, assisting damage is yours. You just don't see that on the scoreboard, okay? That's how the things is working right there. So now we are going to have the slowest part of the game right there. I'm just trying to craft some kind of use for myself. Now when I'm looking back into this replay, you know what I could do? I could relocate like this, right? And I could try to go maybe all the way around or something. Anyways, now when I'm looking at it, I think I could do that and maybe the game would be way, way, way better. But you know, you can't change it. You are having the same battle only once. And yeah. Anyways, our pattern is going like this. We are not penetrating the pattern. So far we have 3 flat zeros. Well, unless we have that assisting damage, blind assisting damage, right? And like I said, the start of this battle is going to be quite slow. And IS-7 is beautiful tank, but in the same time, IS-7 is kind of bigger than G-Fiesta. What do I mean by saying that is very, very simple thing. With IS-7, if the game is smiling on you, there is a huge chance you are going to hit every single shot of yours, and you can simply smile and shit on literally everyone with a huge smile on your face, right? But if the game is saying, no, I had that kind of battles when you are aiming for the, I don't even know, Bachet 12T. The Bachet 12T is sitting stealth in the bush, you know. He's waiting. He don't have the sixth sense. He's hiding right here. Cuckoo. No one can see me. Cuckoo. You know, and you are hitting him from, let's say like that, 200 meters. And the shell is going into the tracks. And look right here. Is it bad aiming from my side? No, it's not. But unfortunately, we managed only to track IS-3. So if I'm not mistaken, in this battle, I was already hissing like a small kitten. Like, you know, I was already hissing. Because all shots, wherever I am trying to aim, I'm just missing. I'm trying to snapshot, obviously, because Russian tank have opportunity to hit the snapshots. And probably majority of you know that already, right? And I'm trying to craft the angle for IS-3, but I can't. And I'm crying deep inside. And usually, fellas, I'm not showing that kind of games, okay? But this is going to be very, very interesting point right here. Just be patient and wait for it. And that point is pretty much called use every help which you can get into the game. Don't be locked in your small box, you know, or however to say that. You will see everything what I'm talking about when we will reach that position. Anyways, or that minute of the replay. Anyways, What we are doing right here, we are just trying to go a bit more aggressive over there, so maybe we will get some assisting damage and maybe we will spot someone who is fapping next to the red line. There is Death Star which never ever was spotted, so my main and initial thought the Death Star could be over there, but the Scorpion G managed to get a shot on me, which is not the best thing. The Patton managed to get the shot and Patton is being a big pain in the ass. What I did not really understood how our artist did not manage to kill that guy yet, because if I am not mistaken, the artist can actually hit right there. But everything is a luck, to be honest. And it doesn't matter how you are aiming, sometimes you are hitting and sometimes you are missing, right? So what I said, plan B, error, plan B. Yes, I'm going with those kind of snapshots, but skill, then you cannot complain. Fellas, I need to take the risk for that kind of shots with IS-7, because for IS-7 owners, and I believe we have quite some of you which is watching this replay, right? You know me very, very well. And you know the IS-7 very, very well. You can hit the snapshots. As wrong as it sounds, and as big a caliber is on IS-7, which is 130mm, right? It doesn't matter, you can hit those snapshots. And now we have some kind of troubles. There is still a lot of things left to do, and we have only 10 APCRs left, right? We don't have APs left whatsoever, and we have 5 high explosives. They still have Mouse, they still have Fava, they have T-44, IS-3 at least in this side, and still many, many, many vehicles in that area. So I need to figure out how I could get some kind of use. Oh, you little bastard Scorpion. Beautiful. Scorpion is going out. We are on 9 ammunition, not counting high explosives right here. And now the Patton. Patton, could you please pick so I... Ooh, the light tank. Light tank took one for the team. He was quite lucky before, but in the same time, you know, the distance is kind of huge, so call him lucky, it's not the right thing to do, because when the distance is big, you know, for you to hit the shot, it's just, let's say like that, very, very hard and very, very complicated, right? Our artist is trying to splash this guy, and I'm trying to aim, and I'm thinking maybe he's going to do a mistake. That's what I want to see. We have a Fava over there, which is pretty much holding this line over there, and this Su 101, so if they will go in front, Su will spot them, Fava will kill them, so I am feeling quite confident right there, and battle is getting closer and closer. It's 6-6, our Fava just got murdered, which is not very good thing, right? Let's think about it, it's not very good. I have 7 ammunition left, and oh boy, looks like I am in the big trouble right there. I'm sitting in the middle of the nowhere, and the most important tank which needs to die is that Patton, and the Mouse is going in front. Skill thing, what to do, fellas? What you would do in this kind of situation? So let's cap everything out right there. Wait, Mouse, Fava, T-44, IS-3 is right there. You don't have anyone who could support you. MX-13 105 autoloader is in the middle. Patton is right here. Prototype is right here. You are in the crossfire. What you would do? I mean, it's already looking like pizdiets, right? Look, my initial thought, run. Because one-on-one on the pretty much flat ground, I can't do shit for Mouse. Patton, meanwhile, got clicked by the Arte, which is very, very good thing. So what I'm doing, I'm... activating the super duper hyper turbo boost, and I can tell you that I prefer IS-7 any day, any time, instead of playing with the Mouse. So look right there, pay attention. So what is happening right here? I am going for that Mouse once again, and I notice that, oh my bananas, Mouse is right there, he's going. He is shooting APCRs, he did not manage to penetrate me. So, what kind of options do I have? I can fight against him like this, I'm pretty much 3-shotable for him, or 2-shotable if he is going to be lucky. I can fight on the flat ground, or I can leave him and I can go for a prototype or links or whatever, right? But look at this thing. Look at this thing, fellas. I am thinking, what the flying F I supposed to do? Error. I'm going back. You know why I'm going back? Look at this. Look in front of this. What we have right here, we have the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful cover, which the game RNG, let's say like that, provided for us. And now we are going to have a good time with the mouse. Now, like, to be honest, what this mouse can do, he can go and F himself. But scale mouse can rush on you. Now look, you see, the main reason why the mouse is not rushing on me. Arta TS5. If mouse will go like this, you see this lovely pigeon over there, he will get the shots into the mouse, and then mouse will have a lot of problems. So although we don't really have too many ammunition left, but we can shit on this mouse with a big smile on our face, and this poor soul can't do shit. We have 4 in the magazine left, we have 4 APCRs left in general. And the mouse is trying to go down, okay? So I'm leaving this Vaza corpse just in case to help us, let's say like that. And I am thinking about going in front, but I saw the mouse going in front once again, which is okay. And I decided to take the Vaza together with me, right? So what this mouse can do right now for me, even though he have, let's say like that, a better situation, right? Not better situation, I have better situation just because of this corpse. But mouse pretty much one-on-one will always kill IS-7, because IS-7 DPM is not that good as mouses, and so on. You get the point what I'm saying. Now skill, why you saw the replay? I'm paying attention at the maximap. You think I don't see this guy? I see him. I'm ignoring him. Why so? For him to penetrate me, it's a very, very hard thing. Plus, on top of that, I have a sky shits, which is actually supporting. So, hip hip hooray. 3 shots in the magazine, 3 shots left in general. So, now I'm trying to get a good angle to shoot this Mr. Mouse. We are trying to craft it. Yes, fellas. We are crafting the angle right here. We left that Vaza, which was probably more useful by being dead than by being alive, because he's a tier 8 tank in this kind of matchup. So, you know, hashtag never lucky. Anyways, mouse is already on the full rage mode, probably, and mouse is saying, Škoda is going for us. We are paying attention at the max map, and Škoda is going down right here. Last APCR left for Mr. Mouse, and I am thinking how to eliminate him. Obviously, currently I'm on the reload. Mouse is saying, oh my bananas, I hate this tank, and Mouse is going down just like this. I mean, okay, look. The score is not epic of this battle, but what we have done right here, everyone is getting in those shitty ass situations when you simply cannot do anything, okay? You are getting into them, I am getting into them, and we need to think how we can get maximum use of the current game situation, current moment, and so on. So look around. Maybe you are going to see some kind of rock which you never ever saw before. Maybe you are going to see the Vaza light tank which died like 3 minutes ago, and you can use it. You get the point what I'm saying, right? So here you go. This is the most important thing of all this replay. And right here, if you are wondering what is going to happen next, I try to invite my teammates for rigging Brother in Arms, because 3 kills each is Brother in Arms medal, and we are not going to even try to chase this IS-3. And this IS-3 said, I'm a submarine. Here you go, fellas. This is your daily dose of skill. I hope you enjoyed this one. And for the Sunday daily dose, even though we don't have, usually we are not uploading the replays there, but we will. Yesterday we played with a Klaus Kellerman. It was a blast. And there was some good games, there was some bad games. There was very, very interesting. It was a very, very interesting stream. I had a lot of laughs and giggles, and I enjoyed myself. And that was second date with Klaus Kellerman. So feel free to check his channel out today, tomorrow, or after 2 weeks, whatever. However you prefer that. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. That was your daily dose of skill. Peace, fellas.